Welcome to Power Electronics Lecture Series. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you buck converter in this session. So to understand buck converter, these are my session outlines, where first I'll be going to explain basics of buck converter. After that, I'll explain circuit of buck converter. Then after, we will see different modes of buck converter, and along with that, we will see its working. And then after, I'll show you waveforms of buck converter, and based on waveforms and working, we will see parameters of buck converter. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of buck converter. Now see, buck converter, that is step down DC to DC converter. So here buck converter is step down DC to DC converter. And as its name suggests, buck means step down. Step down means voltage will decrease. So here at output side, you will be observing voltage is less compared to input voltage at load side. And as we decrease voltage, there will be increase in current. So current gets step up in buck converter. Buck converter can be very highly efficient, and that efficiency could be greater than 90%. And because of that, we use buck converter in computer from main supply with 12 voltage to different elements like USB, dynamic RAM or CPU. And that has been functioning at the voltage 1.8 to 4.2 voltage. So here main supply, that is there with 12 voltage, and that supply is been distributed to different elements like USB, dynamic RAM and CPU, which is functioning with the different voltage ranges from 1.8 voltage to 4.2 voltages. So that is where we use buck converter. And by using buck converter, even we can make effective SMPS. So switch mode power supply, that even can be made by using buck converter. So these are the basics. So let us try to understand basic circuit which is there with buck converter. So as if you see buck converter basic circuit, then here we have DC supply. So this DC supply that we are dealing with to utilize in buck converter, where at load side by using this circuit we'll be having less voltage. So here we use one switch. Here we have freewheeling diode. Here we are connecting inductor in series with load, where across load we connect one capacitor, and here we are taking our output voltage. So in buck converter, you will be observing there will be less average output DC voltage compared to supply voltage VS. So let us try to understand how this buck converter functions. So as I have told you, this is the basic circuit in which there are two modes. In one mode, switch will be on, and in one mode, switch will be off. So what will happen as if switch is on? So when you turn on this switch, at that time, the supply voltage that will flow current in this loop. So you can observe from supply voltage to switch to inductor, current is flowing, and current will flow through the load, as well as partial current will flow in this capacitor. So you can see as if switch is on, current will flow in this loop. When switch is on, this inductor will get charge, and its polarity of charging will be plus minus like this. So during switch is on, current will flow in this loop through the load, as well as partial current will flow through the capacitor, and inductor will get charge by polarity plus minus. So this is what the first mode, which is there with buck converter, where switch is on. Now what if this switch is off? So when switch is off, at that time the charged energy which is there in inductor with plus minus polarity, that inductor will reverse its polarity. So now it will get minus plus, you can see, and then inductor will release its energy through the load. So you can see through the load current will flow in this loop. So current will flow from inductor to load to freewheeling diode, and partial current that will even flow through capacitor. So this is how current will flow in this loop, you can observe. So there are two modes. In one mode, when switch is on, inductor will store energy with plus minus polarity, and When switch is off, inductor will release its energy by changing its polarity in this loop. In this case, freewheeling diode will conduct. So this is the modes which is there with buck converter. Now let us try to understand waveforms based on these modes. So you can observe this is the basic circuit, and here in waveforms we are dealing with to plot output voltage V0, inductor current, diode current, input current and capacitor current. So here all those waveforms that we are dealing with to plot based on switch is on and switch is off. So here I in current that will flow from the supply from here, and this is what IL inductor current, and this is capacitor current and output current that you can see. Now here, and when switch is on, at that time inductor will charge by polarity plus minus like this, and when switch is off, at that time inductor will release its energy by changing its polarity. So here at output side, first we are dealing with to see what will happen when switch is on and what will happen when switch is off. So here for this time period, I have provided turn on operation of this switch and turn off operation of this switch that you can see. Now, as I have told you, when switch is on, current will flow in this loop and partial current flow will capacitor that you can see, right? And during switch is on, inductor will store energy. So current will increase gradually with plus minus polarity in this direction, right? And you can observe at that time output voltage that will appear, which is Vs, right? Or one can say DC voltage VDC. And when switch is off, at that time freewheeling diode will conduct and inductor will release its energy, so current will flow in this loop. So at that time, as freewheeling diode is conducting, output voltage that will be minimum, or one can say zero, at load side. So that you can see output voltage that will be VDC during T is on, and output voltage is minimum or zero during switch is off. So when switch is on, inductor current will increase from Imin to Imax, and when switch is off, at that time inductor current will decrease from Imax to Imin. So this is how waveforms are there across inductor that you can see. So during switch is on, inductor current will increase from minimum to maximum, and when switch is off, at that time inductor current will decrease from maximum to minimum. And you can observe when switch is off, at that time this freewheeling diode will conduct. So this diode current that will be appearing during switch is off, and when switch is on, at that time freewheeling diode will be in reverse bias, so there will be zero current. So when switch is on, freewheeling diode will not conduct, so current will be zero. And when switch is on, this current of inductor that will appear across diode, and input current, I in current, that will appear when switch is on, right? And when switch is off, at that time this input current that will not flow, so that you can see. So this is what input current which is happening because of VDC during switch is on, and this input current is not flowing because of switch is off, so it will be zero during T off. And capacitor current that will flow like this, and it will be having very less value, and average capacitor current that will be zero. I'll show you in calculation how it will be zero. So let us try to understand all those calculation. See, capacitor current is happening like this, this average current that you can see, it is zero. How it is zero? So let us try to understand that in parameters. So this is the basic circuit that we have already seen, and these are the waveforms that I have already explained you how that is happening. Now, as I have told you, what will happen when this switch is on? So as if this switch is on, you will be observing this current is flowing from supply in this loop, you can see, and this diode will be off. So if you want to calculate inductor voltage during switch is on, then see this inductor voltage VL, as per this loop You can say this VL will be VS minus V0. And if you calculate IC current, then if you apply Kirchhoff node law at this node, then this is IL current, then IC on current, that will be IL minus I0. And when this switch is off, at that time, this inductor will release its energy and current will flow in this loop. So you'll be observing this VL voltage plus V0 voltage, that will be zero. So we can say VL off voltage, that will be equals to minus V0. And regarding IC off current, we can say it is IL minus I0. Now, based on this, we will apply volt second balance. So see, if we apply volt second balance across inductor voltage, then we can say VL on into T on plus VL off into T off, that is equals to zero. And VL on that we have calculated, it is VS minus V0, and VL off that we have calculated, it is minus V0. So let us place it over here. And T on, that is duty cycle into T. Now that we already know, like see, duty cycle is T on divided by T. So T on is equals to D into T, that you can see it over here. And T off, that is 1 minus duty cycle into T. And if you solve this, then you'll be finding it is V0 is equals to duty cycle into VS. So our average output voltage in this buck converter, that is duty cycle into VS. Now you see duty cycle range, that is there from 0 to 1. It cannot be greater than 1. So duty cycle is 0 to 1. So output, average output voltage, that is always less than supply voltage VS. So here our average output voltage is always less than supply voltage VS. We can say this is a buck converter. So here duty cycle is always less than 1. It is ranging in between 0 to 1. So this type of chopper is referred as step down chopper, and even this converter is even referred as buck converter. Now let us apply current second balance. So if we apply ampere second balance, then that ampere second balance, now that we will apply it for capacitor current. So capacitor current during on into T on plus capacitor current during off into T off, that is equals to zero as per ampere second balance. So IC on into T on plus IC off into T off, that is equals to zero. And IC on, that is IL minus I0, and IC off, that is even IL minus I0. So if we apply this and if we resolve this equation, then you'll be getting IL is equals to I0. So as IL is equals to I0, you'll be observing average DC current of capacitor, that is zero. Why? The reason is IC is equals to IL minus I0. And if IL is equals to I0, what it means, average IC current through capacitor, that is zero. So from this we can say average value of capacitor current is zero. So we can say it is been used to filter DC component at output side, but average current through capacitor will be zero. So in so many books, you will be finding this capacitor current is not drawn, but that capacitor current is happening, but its average value is always zero. And because of that, it does not affect that much in functioning of circuit. And in some books, even you will be finding this capacitor is not used. See, this use of capacitor is just to eliminate AC ripple, which is happening at load side. And if you want to remove AC components, or one can say if you want to bypass that, in that case, we can connect this capacitor across this load. So this is how this buck converter is functioning. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos which will solve your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.